everyone. I'm Laura from Semi Technologies, and in this video I will explain you how to use Weaviate with Jina AI's DocArray. So DocArray is a library to handle unstructured data and to process it, embed it, and search through it really efficiently. So it's a Pythonic API. And with this library, you can use various document stores to store the data. One of the document stores is Weaviate. Weaviate is a vector search engine, and as a vector database, you can store and retrieve data really fast, and it's scalable. So it's a good choice if you go for a large data set in DocArray. So for this demo, I prepared a Jupyter notebook. You can find the code and some example data in this repository, which will be, the link will be in the description of this video. In this example, I will do a similar image search with fashion images from the H&M fashion dataset, which is available from Kaggle. Okay, so before we go to the notebook, it's important to have a Weaviate instance running, so the document store. There are two options to achieve this. First, you can run Weaviate locally. In this case, you will need to have Docker Compose installed. And the other option is to run a Weaviate instance on the cloud. So I will show you both options. I included in the repository a Docker Compose file for Weaviate. And the only thing you need to do is run Docker Compose up to start this Weaviate instance. And then it is running on localhost 8080. So the other option is to run Weaviate from the cloud using Weaviate Cloud Service. For this, you need to create an account on Weaviate Cloud Service. You can go to console.semi.technology. So if you're signed in, you can create a new Weaviate cluster, and that's for free. So you can choose a name here, which will also be the server name or the URL of your Weaviate instance. Important here is to choose none when it asks for the machine learning model to vectorize data, because we will do this in DocArray. So you can choose authentication, and we don't want any demo data set loaded in, and then you can create. So for now I have it running locally. Let's go to the Python notebook. You need to have only two libraries installed. If you install DocArray full, it also installs Weaviate client for you, so that's really convenient. And we use Storage Vision to load in the machine learning model. So first let's load in DocArray. Then we would do some configuration. So I set some variables for the data. Let's only load in like 50 images for now, so we can walk through this demo really fast. You define where the data is located, and I also define already which image I will use for querying. So as mentioned, we have the Weaviate running on localhost port 8080. In case you have a Weaviate instance running on some other location, you need to change the host location here. So this initiates the document array. We see now that there are no documents in there yet because we just initiated it, and we're using Weaviate as backend. So now let's load in data. We will use DocArray's function from files. We choose a data path that we defined, only 50 documents, and we use Weaviate as our storage mechanism. So we see we have 50 documents now in document array. So those are the 50 unpreprocessed images. And we can see them over here. So it's various types of clothing. Then we define a preprocessing method. We want the images to be smaller to handle them fast with the machine learning model. We normalize the color and change the axis. And then we can use documents or DocArray's apply function to use this preprocessing function to all the documents really fast. Okay, so now it preprocessed the 50 documents that we have in there. Next, we will use a machine learning model to create vectors for each image, which is also called embedding or encoding. I use CPU here, but if you have a GPU available, it will recognize this if you use this function. We use a ResNet 50 model, and we use Torch Vision to load in this model. And next, we can use DocArray embed method to embed all the documents that we have saved in Weaviate with the machine learning model, with the CPU, and in this case, batch size of 20. Okay, so in 7 seconds, we have all the 50 images embedded. This step is optional, but I removed the tensor here from all the images because now we have the vector. And by removing the tensor, we free up a lot of memory, which will fasten the query later on. So I recommend you to do this as well, because we don't need the tensor anymore. Okay, so next we can query the dataset, because now we have all the data loaded in. And as I told you before, the query image URL is already defined above. So in this case, we will be querying with this image. And the goal is to find similar images to this image. So we apply the same pre-processing steps. We embed the model as well, because we want a vector for this query as well. And then you can find DocArray's find method to find similar images in the docs that we have saved in Weaviate with the document query, and in this case, a limit of 5 images. Okay, and then we plot the images that we have as a result. So as you can see, these are quite similar to the query image, and it's retrieving from only 50 images. So I think it did a well job. And that's of course done by ResNet 50 model in combination with the vector search engine Weaviate. Okay, that's it. You can play around with it this a bit. You can find the link of the document of the notebook in the description of the video. Okay, thank you.